Hello, hello, welcome to Quackalope. Thank you for being here. Today we're playing Uprising by Nemesis Games. This is a massive cooperative game set in a post-apocalyptic sort of scene where most of the world has been crusted over and turned to ice due to the Emperor casting a spell that opened rifts that allowed these chaos beings to kind of pull through. Why are you nodding at me like this? Look, Max, listen to me. Listen to me, buddy.
I'm listening.
We're working together here.
Can you tell me the title of this?
To increase your losing streak.
Oh, okay.
He's trying to lose on win as a group.
Sean, well, that's fair. Sean, I think if we win together, totally acceptable.
All right.
If we lose...
Because of Max. We still won.
Then his losing streak's increasing.
I sincerely hope at the end of this that it's purple, green, or not purple, red... Purple, green, blue, white.
We'll certainly see how it works. Like I was saying, this is going to be a cooperative game experience. We are working together with our different factions to rise up against both the chaos that is spreading across the land and slowly sinking into the last remnants of human society. Well, and not quite human society. To be fair, there's a lot of different races and creatures and beings that exist
Society.
Society in general. and also hold back. Yeah, and then also hold back the ranks of the Imperial, the Legion, that is spilling out of the capital itself.
Yeah, everything is closing in on you.
Well, it's branching out, and chaos is closing in.
Right.
And we're in the middle.
And we're in the middle.
Yeah.
We're caught in the crossfire.
There's a lot of chaos manipulation and mitigation we're going to have to be doing on the board here. You kind of secure your position, and then you hold on for dear life. I know there's flavor text.
Just do it.
Let's do it. You got to. It's Quackalope.
Okay.
It's Quackalope.
It is
Quackalope. Are we all doing it?
We don't all have to.
We're all doing it.
Okay, we're all going to do it. So let's see here. I am playing as the... I think these names are originally oriented from, I believe, a German language. Mm. And when I was doing my very best to try to pronounce them, I was still getting them wrong, even with the aid of someone who had a skilled ear. So I am the Unbending Highlanders. I'm not going to try the main name.
The Durakar
belonged to the original inhabitants of Azul. Once they followed the great Koleth herds in the plains as nomadic hunters. But as the predatory Munyar raiders and the islands with their ships, the Duakor retreated into the hostile environment of the great mountain ranges. Untouched and almost forgotten, the Duakor established a new life there. The harsh environment formed the slender-statured people into an efficient and hardened community. The Council of Elders has decided since that time on the fate of each individual, and a strict code of honor assigns every member a permanent place in the community. There is little room for individuality, and even less for missteps. The welfare of each clan and its survival are the daily focus of the Durakar. And when the curse devastated the lowlands of Azul and caused the oceans to freeze, the Council of Elders decided to give up on the isolation of the Durakar, since chaos threatened to destroy the livelihood of their people once and for all. My society is a clan-based, my way of life is hunters and gatherers, our leader type is an elder, and our survivors, there are 80,000 of us left.
You got a lot of survivors, bro.
And I'm playing Yanni the Hunter. She is going to be one of the two elders that I could have chosen to lead this charge.
Yeah, the flip side is Laurel.
Yep. And then who are you doing?
All right. I am the Crow, the Forgotten Guardians. The tribes of the Crow have lived on the islands of Azul since the first days. Scholars suppose that this martial and proud race once served the ancient as warriors and guardians. Today, some Crow tribes still live in the ruins of that vanished civilization and defend it with fervor against any intruder. The Crow have lived in constant warfare with the Moyar, the Empire, and, in fact, all the inhabitants of Azul, not least among the tribes themselves. The Iron Fist of the Empire forced the Crow into the outskirts of Azul and almost completely broke their power. Isolated raids and looting were a nuisance, but not a real threat to the Imperial Order of Azul. The curse hit the weakened tribes hard. Stone buildings were foreign to the warriors and shepherds. Still full of mistrust, the chieftains gathered peacefully for the first time in the history of the Crow to decide who would guide them through these dark times. We are a tribal society. We are riders and herders. The leader is a chieftain, and we only have 30,000 survivors.
Wow, that's a lot of people.
I know.
You are,
you got like, what, 11?
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Who are you playing?
I am the Druin. We are nebulous wanderers. For ages, the Druin roamed the plains and forest of Azul as small packs of nomadic hunters and traders, even if the other races often met them with distrust and even fear of their strangeness. Their reputation as trading partners was without blame. However, the Druin never settled down, even though the villages and towns built by the Moir and the Empire promised posterity and comfort. The Druin preferred to wander about the lands in their tents like banks of mist, unfathomable and full of secrets. A few caravans sought contact with the outside world to trade goods, but most of the communities remained hidden. Those small packs were each led by an Archon. Through enchanted ghost stones carried by these leaders, the Archons were connected with the spirits of their ancestors, who advised them on all decisions with their knowledge and wisdom. When the curse hit Azul, the ancestral spirits summoned all the surviving Druin, knowing that their only chance of survival was a union of all forces. We are a nomadic society, we're traders, leaders are Archons, and we have 10,000 survivors.
Wow!
80, 30, 10.
It's not a lot of people.
No.
Now, I'm not going to give you a full teach on this, both because the way you should learn this game is honestly by getting an overview and then following this chart step by step. There's a lot to learn, but honestly, it's not too complicated of a game, especially, and for any of you that are playing it on TTS, because I know the designers have made it fully accessible in public on TTS. In person, TTS was all right for me to learn. In person, it's way more graspable. Mm. Just wanted to throw that out there. So, here in what exactly is going on with Uprising. We each have our own player boards with unique characters and people that we can bring on. We have a similar set of actions, but each of our leaders have special traits, each of our character decks have special traits or special abilities, and then each of our clansmen or the units we want to bring out onto the board have different resource costs. There's going to be three core resources in this game. Food, which is going to allow you to move around the board. Plunder, which is going to allow you to establish outposts or establish these havens in different regions. And then finally, salt. Gold and wealth and money isn't really a key of this anymore. Really, in this region, salt is what you gather and trade with now. Up here onto this main board. Oh, one last thing about our characters. One unique element of this game is that you're, over the course of the game, through items in your own personal deck, you're going to be building your profile, right? A hand of 10 cards or 10 abilities that modify your actions in different stages of the game. This will always be unique for each one of these tribes, and also grow and change as you're drawing up cards and as you're buying things from the marketplace. For me, this is one of the most interesting elements of the game, even though I think it's a little undernoted.
Also, each tribe has two decks, even two.
That's true. Each tribe has a custom deck based off of which leader you're playing with.
Whole different deck, whole different mini.
Yeah, it's very cool. Oh, and these, this is, of course, a prototype. I feel like I actually have to say it this time. People might look at this and think to themselves, oh, that's clearly a finished game.
Right.
This is a prototype. These will be high-quality acrylic standees with acrylic bases, and, I mean, you know, they're not doing a pile of miniatures, which I actually, in a game like this, the art and the accessibility and the price point of it, I mean, I love the visuals and the love that's been put into the design of this, so...
I prefer that option.
I prefer these acrylic standees, hands down.
Right.
And if they do a miniature pack and a second wave or something down the line for people who want that...
Someone will want to do that.
Sooner or later. But for right now... This, having this already visually
for
on the board.
For accessibility and everything, beautiful. It shows your dice that you get to roll on them. It's pretty nice.
It's really nice. Up here onto the main board, like I was saying, there's really going to be only a few things you should pay attention to. First off, on this far right side, we have our Legion deck, we have our Chaos Graveyard. This is where we'll be summoning the big bads that we're dealing with across the game state. You'll see that happen very soon.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be a problem for us. We also have graveyards where our units go. If we get destroyed, that will score victory points for our opponents. Here in the main board is going to be where we're exploring. This outer wintry land is going to have three regions, the Howling White, the Fog Grave, and finally the Screaming Sea. Those are barren wastelands of snow and misery. And while we can move on to them, we cannot establish outposts or havens in those locations. Instead, chaos itself will be summoning and burrowing in from those outer reaches. Here in the center is going to be the capital, the last bastion of men besides our little tribes of roaming enslaved people. We probably aren't going to take down the capital, but we're certainly going to try to keep the ranks of the Imperial Legion from spreading out from it. We each have our own starting zone, and then we have a mix of unexplored tiles, including spires or pillars that are over here. These will give us some special bonus effects on the map if we go uncover them and figure out what happens.
They're salt towers.
Good, I mean, keywords and terms. I say pretty things, he says accurate ones.
I wouldn't necessarily call most of what you say pretty.
Debatable.
That's Quackalope.
Stop.
It's your channel, we're allowed.
Around the outer edge here is going to be our victory point track. That is what we're paying a lot of attention to.
Mm-hmm.
The goal of the game, there is enough going on that I will not be min-maxing and watching what you're doing. I can't, honestly. But we need to work together as a unit, discussing how we hold back the ranks of chaos so that by the end of the game, all three of us on that victory point track are above both Legion and Chaos. If we are tied or underneath, if even one of us is tied or underneath, all of us are unable to band together, we are unable to hold back the ranks, and we are enslaved for good. If we are underneath it, it says a fate worse than death.
Not good.
Not good. Not good at all. And then finally, over here on the left side, we're going to have some really nice a phase charter here, which walks us through literally every step of this game, just upkeep phase and everything like that. We're also going to have our event decks. There's going to be four of them that you see on the board here. This gameplay, we're only going to play through two chapters in this story.
Mm-hmm. Chapters.
And each chapter has a stack of cards underneath it. You're only ever playing one of these chapters, and you can scale the difficulty based off of how many level 1, 2, 3, and 4 you do. In a classic game, you'd play 1 through 4, scaling in difficulty as you go.
Yeah.
And then finally, we have our marketplace and we have our quest decks. Marketplace is a place where we can shop. Quest decks are things that we can try to achieve that give us in-game bonuses if we can roll the right amount of dice. The game is going to come down to exploration, territory control and securing your foothold, resource management, and then finally, dice rolling and dice mitigation, really maxing out who you're using and how you're utilizing them.
They technically classify this as a 4X, do they not?
Yes, it is classified as a cooperative 4X experience because everything you're doing to earn those victory points and secure your position, you're absolutely hitting those 4 points. I never remember what the 4Xs are.
Explore, expand, exploit, and exterminate. It's right there.
Explore, expand, exploit, and exterminate. Apparently, Endeavor's not in there. Who would have known? Whatever the case. It could have been envision. It could have been eat. I mean, there's a lot of other.
Eat. We have food.
There's a lot of other things that start with an sure. E and, you know, mathematically end with an X. But whatever the case, I think we should get started. How do we start at the top of the phase here, Sean?
So we're gonna skip through a lot of this refresh part
on the first turn.
On the first turn, that's a lot of refreshing our tableau and whatnot. So we'll go down to the event phase. And
why are you playing footsie with me?
I'm playing Quadzy with you, bro.
He's being cooperative.
That's right.
So we don't have any revealed legions or hordes, so we don't need to do that, but we do need to reveal the first event.
Okay.
Here we go.
And we resolve it. The Last Harvest.
Ooh.
Every player gains 2 food.
I'm cool with that.
I'll take some food.
So gain your 2 food.
Can I have one?
I'll consider it.
Thanks, babe.
I don't actually need food, though.
It helps you a lot.
Yeah. It doesn't help me at all.
And we skip the most important part. This is the Last Harvest. The freezing cold mercilessly destroyed every crop, turning food into an invaluable asset. Hence, we gained our 2 food there.
Good to know.
In the Last Harvest. While on the horizon, eerie lights announce the arrival of an even worse threat than hunger. Place 1 horde at threat level 4 in the fogged grave, not adjacent to a haven.
Yeah.
Who'd we get?
The Lich Queen.
All right, stop.
So the Lich Queen is going to start down.
Custom artwork here. She's absolutely terrifying and beautiful.
And she starts at level 4, correct?
Yes, threat level 4.
In what location?
Fog Grave.
So somewhere down here in the Fog Grave.
Not adjacent to his haven.
I mean, I could just go, like, if we put her right next to me.
Well, you she can't go next to your haven.
Oh, okay. Yeah. They did say that. Mm-hmm. If I listened.
Well, it's never been your strong suit.
Dang straight.
Next, we're going to replace 1 additional horde.
Oh, okay. No.
Again, at threat level 4 in the Screaming Sea, not adjacent to a haven.
Pause. Immediate effect.
Oh, no.
Place 1 curse on her hex.
Okay.
If there are less than 5 curses, 1, 2, 3, 4,
oh,
they
no.
gain 5 victory points.
That's a bad way to start.
That's a terrible.
That's
way
a
to
bad
start.
Way to start.
Oh. And then an additional horde spawning again at level 4. You said, Sean, correct?
Who did we get this time?
The Counter of Omens.
Counter of Omens.
Immediately place 2 skeletons on his hex.
Or don't. Where's that coming?
In the Screaming Sea, so up near your home near base, you, buddy. Not adjacent to your haven.
Yeah, that's a good spot.
Cut off this way.
Oh, okay. But okay, yeah, I'm fine with that.
Okay.
All right.
So that is that, and then we resolve all bottom effects from the current event. We did that.
Mm-hmm.
Place 1 activation token on every horde and legion.
And these will trigger, so these cards could actually get multiple activation tokens through different sequences of events. If that happens, they'll trigger multiple times.
Right.
But it's nice because you get to control a little bit how the world's evolving.
Right. Now we're going to move into the build phase.
Yep.
We're going to draw 2 feats from our deck, keep one, and discard the other. And we have that 10-card limit that Jesse mentioned.
Let's go ahead and go through the feats that we already have. So sure. Over here with me, I have an Elder. Always, that means I could always use it, add any 1 die to any of your rolls outside of combat before rolling.
Wow.
Okay? And I have Koloth, Archery and Clash. Discard this, then destroy your Koloth here to ignore all wounds on your enemy's dice. Mm. So I destroy my biggest creature, but if it's like a Hail Mary, if it's like the last bastion.
He absorbed all the attack, basically.
He's a big elephant. He ran in front.
Yeah.
What do you all have?
I have Intuition. It's an always ability. You may use any item, even if my attributes are not high enough. So our heroes have attributes down here, and normally these items require a certain level
to collect them.
But I can ignore that.
Cool.
That's pretty nice. And Sword Sisters. I can flip this card during the actions phase to gain 1 salt for every one of my Sword Sisters that are out on the map.
Okay.
I've got a Dark Ritual. During the clash phase, I can remove a unit from my reserve from the game to gain...
Wow.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, I haven't done that yet. I still don't even fully understand it, so you can walk me through this right now. To gain, if I remove a basic unit, I gave a shield... Oh, I understand it.
A lightning bolt.
And if I remove an elite unit, I get a skull and a lightning bolt.
That is a price to pay.
Yeah, as before damage on
so
my
hero's
hex. So
it's after your roll, but before damage. So you can see how crappily you roll.
I mean, that is a price to pay.
Right. Yeah. Then I also have another clash. This is trolls. If they were destroyed here, I get to roll 1 black die.
Okay.
And I can reroll if I get a lightning bolt.
And okay.
That's and
trolls
damage.
Is one of your units? Oh, yep. It's your biggest unit.
It's my biggest unit.
Okay. And then I think I'm going to go ahead and select a card called Glory. This will give me a clash ability. Flip this to lose 1 shield and gain 1 lightning bolt. Now, Let me specify what lightning bolts do. Lightning bolts allow you to trigger a druid ability. Every round, we're going to be summoning 1 more of these magic beings into existence. The first one here. If we roll a lightning bolt, we can activate this ability. Archery and Clash. Gain 1 resource shown on this hex.
Mm.
Before damage, once per round. So you get a little... Summon some goods up from the earth while you're fighting. Cool.
I have either Assassins, which is pay 1 salt to turn any of one of your dice to show a single hit before damage is assigned. Mm-hmm. Or Ambush, reroll up to 2 of your dice. Rerolling dice is always a good thing. But an automatic hit... is guaranteed, so I'm gonna go with that.
Okay. I think it's reasonable.
So I have a Warg archery card. If I have 2 or more Wargs here, which Wargs are my elite riders,
mm-hmm.
I gain 1 orange die before rolling.
Strong die.
Then I also have the Bonfires action. Discard this to gain 1 basic unit on any of your havens for every horde and legion on the map.
Mm.
So the one question I have with that is, do I have to spend the cost to gain them?
That's not what it says.
So I think that it would be smart to start with that.
Summon some.
And I can immediately start 2 Deadeyes.
Well, you do it during the actions phase.
Yep, not right now, but yeah. But I mean, I can summon 5.
Or you could save it until we feel like we're falling apart. Because you do have to discard that.
True, but
so
I don't
discards wanna... just go to the bottom of your deck, though, so we'll eventually...
So do we want to start it strong, or do we want to...
I feel like I want to start strong. We'll see, though. We'll see what happens.
All right.
I'm going to keep that one.
So we've done that. Now we build any units, towers, or walls on any of our havens.
Yeah.
There's a five units per hex max.
Yeah, and we're doing this together, so we can just go ahead and start summoning. We're going to be paying attention to the cost down here at the bottom, and we could also always use an activation to take a trade action to gain a little bit more salt. That's the only thing you can do outside of your normal sequence of play. Right. Getting five units down on the board is supposed to be pretty valuable. That's both what the creator and the rulebook said, because establishing some dominance early on and then watching it crumble or at least be encroached upon is kind of how this game goes. And if you know me, I love games that don't apologize and beat me up.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're going to go ahead and build our starting units.
Yeah, go ahead and build your starting units.
A number of them.
And the other thing I want to mention is, with the lore and with the theme of this game, there is so much flavor text and behind the scenes that I don't have in this prototype copy. I believe they're working on ways to incorporate and tell the story of like all the little units and pieces. Like I'm excited for that just off of the back of what I want a lore book that just describes to me this world that I'm living in. I'm encapsulated by this theming. So let's see here. I'm definitely paying. Now, we want to hold on to at least one, or at least enough to build, to move our unit and build a haven. Mm-hmm. So let's keep that in the back of your mind. It's going to cost, for me, it's going to cost two to build a haven, and it's going to cost one for me to command my units around. So I'm just going to go ahead and designate those. What have you decided to build? What have you guys got on here?
So I went and built one Deadeye, which is my basic archer, and one warg, which is my elite rider, and three tribesmen. Now, I did that because of this action card that I'm going to use on one of my coming turns, which I can discard to gain one basic unit for every horde and liege on the map, which is two at this point in time. Mm-hmm. So I get two basic units, so I'm going to eventually spawn both of my other basic archers, which have a greater cost than my tribesmen, for free in the coming moves.
Okay.
So that was my thought process behind that. I did not have enough salt to do any more wargs or troll or anything like that, so.
And I put four sword sisters out on the board because I'm planning on flipping this card to get four salt back, and I added one basic archer to have some range attack.
Yeah, I couldn't really afford my heavier people. I ended up with two basic younglings, and I did, or three basic younglings, and I did two spear slingers. So I have a little bit of range control. I couldn't pay what those Oathsworn and people cost.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that's going to be that phase.
So then we move on to the actions phase, and now we're going to take turns taking one action at a time.
So let me talk a little bit about what actions we could potentially take so viewers know what we're talking about. We could spend a activation to move, and we all have eight of these when we start the game. So spend an activation to move. We could do a trade, which is going to get us resources,
but
also
done that twice.
Trade. I did. I had to get my units out. I needed two extra salt.
All right.
I hear what you're saying. I'm going to rely on you to establish control here. I just have the men. We could also trade between each other, resources and everything like that. So if we were in the same hex,
if our heroes are in the same hex,
We can command, which is going to move. We're going to pinpoint a location and then summon everyone up to five from any surrounding locations. We could explore, which is where we flip a tile. You'll see us do that very quickly. A haven is what's going to score us victory points, but also establish some board presence and control. It will also be what the AI system starts to target. The market, you're going to gain one item from the market, which is going to be up there, paying, of course, the salt cost for that. Mm-hmm. And then finally, quest. You can choose to go after a quest, rolling your die on your hero card, trying to accomplish the top sequences. And when we do that, we'll go through that.
Right.
Let's go ahead and talk about what quests we have on the board.
Sure.
So we can keep that in mind. So, you want to start?
Sure. The Druidic Prophetess. It is, you either get three skulls, one shield, or one bolt.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is the success that you would solve this down here. And these cards have three different things. So if you hit all of them, you could get eventually three rewards. This only has one under the skulls.
And you need to solve two of those top equations in order to do a resolved one.
Right. So if you hit two of those, then solve says, take this card. When a curse is placed, place one basic unit of any player on any of their havens.
Ooh.
Now, if you do fail this quest, Chaos gains two victory points.
Well, you know. I have Mad Crone Shaman.
That's me.
It is. I have one of your people.
I'm a crow.
Let's see here. You need to accomplish one of these. It is four damage, one shield, or two lightning bolts. And if you solve it, Choose any hex, destroy any skeletons there, and gain one victory point for each. Discard this quest.
Nice.
Okay.
And I have Nethersea Navigators. It needs one completed to solve. That can either be four skulls, one armor, one shield, or one lightning bolt. If I do complete the shield, I get to draw a new quest, which would fill back in where this one is removed. If I get the lightning bolt, I can discard any items from the market. If I solve it, every player gains one resource for each shield and lightning bolt I rolled, and I discard this quest.
Okay.
And if my hero is on a sea tower hex, I get to toss an extra purple die in there.
And there's something like that on the bottom of each of the quests.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realize y'all didn't read that. Yeah. Sorry.
So, let's see here. You guys mind if I go ahead and start?
Sure, you have the least actions already. May as well start.
I do.
Knock them out of the way.
I'm going to do a move action, and I'm going to push into this plunder zone because if I can gain a little bit more plunder, that could be beneficial for hiring more units. So let's see what I get. Tombs of the Elder Kings. Gain one plunder. They have one of those. Remove any garrisons here. Place two skeletons here. Perfect. So two of my skeleton bros are coming over.
Getting hot and heavy up there already.
That's going to be an issue. I might just have to focus on dealing with that.
You'll be fine.
I haven't done my command. Okay. That's gonna end my turn, though, because I did... that's not going to end my turn. I just moved.
You moved and explored. No, you did explore.
Oh, I did. Yes, sorry. Yeah, yep.
You're good. Okay, I'm also going to move. Now, I would really like to get some more of this as well so I can possibly build two havens in the future, but I'd also really like to just... get rid of that Lich Queen real early on.
We know they're going to start scaling pretty heavily at the end of every round.
And I think if I can move, explore, place a haven, spawn these two other guys, move all in as one, I think that's looking pretty good if I can do that quickly. So, first option is going to be to move here where the food is. I'm also going to go ahead and explore. I'll go ahead and put one there for that as well. This is Bruthgard. I gain two food, which is great for me.
Okay.
If it's empty, I place two skeletons here.
Okay. You can do that, though. You can deal with that.
Yeah, I can handle that.
Probably not, but that's okay.
And you can probably see that your first turn is almost always going to be move and explore.
You've got to open up this map a little bit.
And you want to get havens out there, because that's how we score points.
Yep.
So I'm going to go try to get some more plunder, too. I've got the Frosthold Pass. Gain two plunder. Nice. If empty, place a garrison here. It's not good.
Okay.
And that's it.
Okay. Back over to me. I'm going to go ahead and use this little elephant I have placed over here, and I'm going to do a command action. I want to clear those skeletons off and go ahead and build a haven in that location if I can. So we're moving in.
Bringing in the clan.
We're bringing everyone with us, and I'm opening them up so I can see what type of dice I'm rolling. So... in combat, it's always going to be head-to-head dice, but there's a little bit of a sequence to it, right? So in the combat phase, we're going to start with the archery. So we're referencing, I have two skeletons. Skeletons have no archery abilities. They're all melee. So I will get to roll two white just to begin the combat.
Hopefully knock them out.
I didn't.
It's a Jesse
roll. Well, you know, things happen. Things happen for the best of reasons.
Now you're moving on to combat.
So that I can continue showing you how combat works. Combat is now going to resolve... skeletons versus me, we both roll, we both resolve attacks. They're going to be rolling two red.
Two red dice.
If you want to roll these two red, you can roll them kind of off the board here. And I'll roll this. Well, don't do it yet. Roll them like right there.
I will. I'm working on it.
Think about it a little bit. Calm down. You're shaking your hand like you're ready to
do things. Your archers also attack again.
My archers will attack again because they have melee. And I have three younglings. Okay. You know what? Go ahead and give that back to me. No. I don't trust.
Bam. You're welcome.
Well, I got three shields.
That does nothing, Jesse.
You defended very well.
Now, we're going to continue facing off until one of us is completely wiped. All right, now you need to
stop. That's a lightning bolt and
now you need to
a
stop.
Skull.
I got three skull. What's your lightning bolt?
So they're going to get another.
After damage,
so
they're
going to
spawn another one. So I wipe them out. They wipe out one of me.
And then one of them
so
stays
that goes
there.
To their graveyard. To Chaos's graveyard.
Chaos graveyard.
You're right.
I know.
The look isn't because you're not right.
No, and they've already got 5 points.
Okay, maybe you should roll better.
I will get a point for destroying two of them. Now, only one of them is going to be facing off.
Skull.
Please tell me I wiped it.
You blocked it.
I blocked it, and I wiped. I angrily destroyed it.
So you got rid of three.
Three victory points for you.
Three for you.
Okay, and I've secured this location, and I think I'm going to plant my flag there, and then probably try to take care of that last bastion that we have. What are you thinking, my friend?
Okay. I am going to go ahead. Now, one question before I continue.
Tell me about it. Ask that question.
You can only spawn five units at a time. But no. Can you have 7 units on a single tile?
No, it's 5 units permanent on a tile, but now that we have more havens out here, you could actually spawn more.
Well, when you get more
if havens you had out. The resources, yeah. Yeah. So you could spawn, you could summon, if you had 2 havens, you could presumably summon 10.
Yeah.
But it's always a limit of 5 on a single
tile. So really, spawning these additional 2 doesn't do a whole lot for
it me. It does, because it doesn't cost you the resources, and it gets more board control, which could be
big. Right, and the archers are far and away better than the tribesmen, because their dice is better, and they attack both ranged and normal.
Well, their dice are different. Their dice are different. White and orange are...
I do believe white is better than orange, but...
White has defense.
White and orange,
orange is all offense.
Okay. Orange has a better chance of getting one hit, but doesn't have any block.
Yeah. Okay, gotcha. Yeah. Cool, good to know, So I'm going to go ahead and spend an action to command. We're going
to
go ahead and move all
don't
5
your food when you command.
Of these fellows.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you.
Boop.
I'm going to lay them right here just for like you said, sakes of reading them real quick. But I'll move them in a minute. I get... I have 1 range, so I'm going to get 1 white die before they do anything.
White. There you go.
1's knocked.
There you go.
One of them.
So, and then I'm going to go ahead and I get 1 white, 1 red, and 3 orange.
White, red, 3 orange. There's your 3 orange, and I think you already have a red.
1 red skeleton.
1 white, 1 red, 3 orange. Skeleton?
Nothing.
Super dead.
I think you got it.
Good
super
hit.
Dead.
Good
so,
hit.
2 victory points for red up there. And we have successfully taken over.
I already gave
over.
Him. I already
oh,
gave
for the first
him
one,
yeah,
so there's the second
one.
Perfect.
And that's that turn.
Okay.
All right. Well, I'm going to do the same thing.
Dealing with the
garrison.
The outpost
the
there.
Garrison, yep. Yeah.
So we're going to bring in those 5 guys are going to roll in there.
Okay.
I do have 1 Sons of the Bow who will get to roll a white die.
Mm-hmm.
But their garrison, I believe, also has range.
Garrison over here is
going
to have 1 range, so it'll be white to white. Yes, you do yours first.
Of course.
Blanks.
And Jesse hits me. We'll ping the swordsman.
You know.
Into the Imperial Graveyard.
All right. Now it's straight up. So
now I get 3 orange and 1 white.
And they're a blue and a white.
All right, let's do
2 shields.
2 shields.
But no damage.
Jesse,
can
Max roll more?
Stop,
can Max roll for me? He rolled blanks.
I was a good...
And they blocked both of my hits.
I roll good sometimes.
I did really well at letting Jesse defeat them.
I roll good sometimes.
I don't know. Here we go.
Here we go, Sean. I love you. I'm sorry, Sean.
Shield and a hit. Shield. Or I mean a hit. So,
you take
they blocked and I lose another one. This is not going well. All
right, keep going.
Graveyard.
Are we
sure? I rolled an extra die that I shouldn't have rolled that time.
Well, he's in
it's
there.
It's not like it helped you.
He's in there now. He's combating now. That's true. It's not.
Oh.
What do you have?
Oh, he could have paid his salt to deal direct damage, right?
And that would end it. You could do it right now.
I have to do it before damage, though, so I think we got to roll 1 more time.
You could do it right now.
You think I could do it
because
before?
Because you just rolled and took damage.
Okay.
So you could have done it.
Yeah, you could have done it then.
So I can pay my last salt to trigger that.
So it's dead.
To kill them.
So at least you don't have to go
mask.
Through another. Yeah, that was rough.
You do get a point.
I get a point. Woohoo!
There you go. You're on the board.
That was a little... They're going to get 4.
Jesse, I think your dice rolling has rubbed off on me.
Yeah, that was a little rough. Hey, it wasn't the 5 blanks we saw earlier.
Okay, and I'm going to do this now before I lose any more sword sisters, because I get 2 salt back. I should have done that at the beginning of my turn when I would have gotten 4, which is what I had planned, but I forgot. Anyway. Your turn!
You know, I'm going to look at my cards down here.
Yes, we are not cooperatively playing well.
Right now. Man.
All right.
This is a great beginning.
Here's what I'm thinking.
This is excellent.
I'm going to establish
that's going to be in the comments. Why didn't that idiot flip that card at the beginning of his turn?
No. It might be, why didn't he flip his card at the beginning of the turn? We don't abide by name calling. If you say idiot, step too far. This is still just a fun game on the internet. That being said, I'm establishing a haven. This is being popped down right here. This will gain me plunder, which is what I need at the top of my turn. So that's actually a good thing for me to do.
And it gets you more resources when you produce.
It does. That's the other key thing.
Ooh, that's interesting that I didn't realize that. This is not strictly better for me. If I had 0 havens, I would have gotten 2 plunder. Which...
But the point scoring is better for you.
You get 2 points per haven on the board.
2 points per haven on the board.
So you want to get... And that's,
point.
That's
okay.
The main thing.
Good
we
point.
Can't lose focus.
You need to go up that track, man.
Here's my 3.
Oh, but this is better for you. 3 elephants are more
powerful.
Shush.
It's fine. But, see, it cost me 3, so I can't build another haven unless I explore into a different area. But I feel like I need to kill that Lich Queen, so we're going to see what's going to happen.
I don't
haven built.
Haven built.
Cool.
So I, too, am going to build a haven in my cleared area.
Yeah, and what we found from the beginning rounds of this is establishing,
Yeah, this is where it's all starting. I mean, we need presence. Control. Yes. Oh, yeah,
and these guys moved in there.
Yeah, we have to have presence. Metal.
Okay. I'm now thinking I start diverting from what we are all doing the same.
Sure.
Fight the omens.
Yeah.
Take it to them.
Can I just see what they...
They're nasty.
They're pretty gross. We'll flip these vertically while we're fighting them, just for our ease of use, please.
I think I need to take them on, though, because they're going to scale so much so fast.
They likely will, yeah.
Yeah. Each round, if they stay out, their threat level increases 2. So they're not going to get any easier.
Mess. All right. So I'm going to pay 1 food. Can I have 2 back, please?
Yep.
And I'm going to do a command action into this location. Now, I'm not going to bring my hero with me, because I don't need to.
He doesn't contribute to combat.
Yeah, they don't actually do anything with the combat.
No, your hero is more like a scout, honestly.
Yeah, he does the questing.
And they're not held off. Now, sometimes they do need to be in regions and things to do some of the quests and challenges. Yeah. But in this case, we're not going to do that.
Okay.
We're immediately fighting. I believe I start against the skeletons. No, they roll all together,
actually.
They're
all going to roll together,
but
yeah.
I have to hit the skeletons first.
Yes, I believe so. So
I forgot there was even skeletons there. All right.
They're going to roll 3 white die.
Archery ways.
Yep, here's 1. Oh, wait. That's 1 too many. Yep, 1 too
many. Okay. I'm rolling 2 white die.
Hey,
hitting the shield. Don't do it.
1 hit. Okay. Perfect.
Take off a skeleton for me.
Ping 1.
What XP?
Put him right here so I remember that I'm getting that XP from him.
Okay, good idea.
We're past the archery phase now. Let's move on to the straight-up combat.
Ooh, here's where the big dogs come
blue,
in play.
Blue, white, white.
I need, Sean.
What do you need?
Purple, blue, orange, and red.
Okay, I see a lot of those dice over there already.
Purple, blue, orange, and red.
Set it up there. All right, I gave him the thing because I don't need it as much.
He's got a lot of
purple,
dice.
blue.
What do I have?
Orange, red.
May add any one die. It's not combat. Discard this, then destroy your cola. Flip this to lose 1 shield and gain 1.
That doesn't really help.
Could be helpful.
I could get a resource.
Ooh, that's not a great roll for you, Jesse. Oh my God! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and. Place 2 skeletons on an empty hex.
Oh, shit.
Chaos graveyard.
Wow, dude.
Oh. Now, I already have 1 there, so it won't score anymore.
Yeah, because it's for diversity of factions is how they score. Yeah.
That's true.
In their graveyard.
If we get an event that triggers differently, we'll remember. Yeah. But
so, we get to place these on any empty hex.
Well, just for sake of it.
That was like my role.
Not good. Where do you want these to go? Not near you, I assume. Let's put these guys over here.
Any empty hex.
Yeah. Let's just move them away from that.
Yeah.
That was scary.
Ow.
I thought I'd do something.
I did too, Jesse. I think we all thought you would do something. You did something.
It's like that scene in Game of Thrones where you're like wandering through the snow and then just a pile of skeletons overrun your ranks. You see this Lich Queen, like what is she? She's
The Counter of Omens.
She's the Counter of Omens. She like rises up above like the white. She's like,
you dare come out to my domain?
Yeah, you know how snow is such an absorbing, blinding light? Mm-hmm. Well, that same atmosphere, that feeling of being blinded, but instead it's darkness. You just see that like a black
overwhelming.
Hole.
Overwhelming.
And then you just see skeletons running.
Yeah, that was not
and
that
my,
very good.
My character just from like the past there hears screaming. Oh, I did notice one thing that I would have positioned differently if I had seen it. The white edges of that are going to be impassable terrain. So because I was planning on moving there, I needed to place that tile down in a position that allowed me to do so. You also have some impassable terrain there.
I would appreciate
Do I as well? I don't think so.
I don't think so. I just didn't...
I had forgotten about that. So
I just didn't see it when I put it down.
Good call.
That would allow you to go there. Yep.
Okay.
But it won't let me go to the sea tower.
It won't.
Salt tower. But
it
I want to go.
Well, you know, your person could.
Yeah, your person can.
Your person's not
my hero can, but my units can't.
Your units could not. Yep.
It seems like you're not coming to help me with the Lich Queen.
If you opened this up, then potentially he could move into that spot. Mm. So, All right, well, that's my thing.
Ouch.
I don't love it.
No.
See, I was really hoping to go fight the Lich Queen.
Maybe you shouldn't.
No. I know, you've really made me think that, but...
But if we don't,
I know. And it's not like I'm going to get any better.
It's not.
You could get stronger units out there, though.
I mean, I could.
That was such a... And it wasn't even the dice. I probably should have seen that. With the skeleton guard on her already.
Yeah.
Because if you would have hit her immediately, it would have dropped down her threat level.
The skeleton guard on her adding defense meant I was walking into... I mean, I was probably walking into my death. I shouldn't...
It was a bold move.
I should have known better than that.
So I have four more actions.
For some reason, I thought I could do it.
I'd love to move and explore.
Do it.
Then I can't place a haven there until I remove that. So then that would be me not fighting the Lich Queen this round, basically.
I don't know that you need to. She's gonna go. She's gonna move towards your haven.
Yeah, she's gonna get level six.
Oh, she'll actually move into your haven, won't she? Because you're on the
and
on
she's
the
also gonna get level six.
If you leave your units there, they'll fight her when she comes in. If you move and explore and establish, your units will at least stand and defend.
Command.
Oh dear God.
This could be the shortest.
This could be the shortest game we've seen in a long time.
Oh, but remember, I score one victory point.
Ow. You did.
You hit me.
You did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, okay.
It's a blue.
Yeah. I said put it there so we remember.
Right, no.
And then we forgot.
Then got slaughtered.
So, three whites for them.
Oh, for them? What do you get?
One white. Oh, maybe that's why I should have waited.
A shield.
I don't mind that.
You're good.
Nothing. That's fine.
Cool.
So we're out of archery.
Melee range. I need one red.
Does the curse give her any extra boons?
Mm-mm. Okay. It's just there. It just corrupts the land.
Okay.
Three orange. Oh, okay. Three orange, one white, one red. That's all I got. She gets purple, blue, blue, orange, orange.
Purple, blue, blue, orange, orange.
I'm beginning to rethink this.
Too late.
Whoa. Four and a shield.
Whoa.
Go ahead.
What have we done? Wait, how did this not happen the first time? We played the...
We did really well on the first chapter last time.
We played
time.
The run through and defeated these guys like...
Yeah, wiped them.
Early.
Go ahead.
How many? Four?
We're overconfident.
Four hits and a shield.
Our first chapter went so well, we're very overconfident now.
Oh, this is... That was
so
a.
Don't forget through her shields. You do have
you
a
get
lightning
a resource.
Bolt, so you get a resource
I get
shown
one shield.
On that hex, which is nothing.
I get through one shield. You get through one shield, knock her down by a level. And you get
three.
One. You get one resource. There's nothing on this hex though, so you don't get anything.
Yeah.
And
you lose three.
You're gonna lose in three people, and then you're gonna roll again.
Well, bye bye, little orange peoples.
Okay, how's her stats change? Spot. Purple, blue, blue, orange.
She loses a purple, or she loses an orange, yeah.
Oh my god. Maybe I wasn't rolling for the bad person last time.
Oh my god.
Max has rolled nicer for the enemy.
I mean, all I have is a purple and a white. What was that?
Three hits and a shield.
Yeah, that's gonna do it.
You lose your...
They're both dead. Two.
Yeah.
What?! This is not at all
helpful. So I'm going to quest.
Oh my gosh.
should we roll this back?
No.
Red.
No. Oh my gosh.
Purple, white, and orange.
What?
I'm going to attempt the quest here.
Okay.
For the Mad Crow Shaman.
Now let's explain what you're doing.
So
you're rolling your character dice.
Yes, I'm rolling my character dice. So I've got one might, one magic, and then I can get my choice of two white and orange. So I've got those dice, and we're rolling to try to get these successes up here.
No, you don't have quite the right dice in here, do you? You need a red instead of
white. I need a red instead of white. Thank you. That will probably be helpful. All right, so I got three skulls, which isn't good enough.
You did get the shield.
I got one shield. That's good enough.
You got a success, but none of the boons.
I didn't get any extra juice.
Mm-hmm.
That stinks. Now I can choose any hex, destroy any skeletons there.
Well, so I mean, that's got two, yeah.
Wipe these two out, so that'll get me two victory points.
Because if three come together, of course, they turn into a horde.
Right.
So that'll score white two.
Yep. Okay.
And then this quest goes away.
Man, I was one. Fair, we all... didn't start with the chaos scoring 5 immediately either.
Yeah,
this is about as bad as it can go.
Yeah, this is not good.
We had defenses. We had towers.
Right, Jesse, back to you.
Built, yeah.
What happened?
It was false.
We got confident. Yeah. We thought like the first trial went well, and we thought, oh,
we got this.
We understand how to play this game.
We're experts.
So I do understand now that I need far more archers. Because I would have taken her health down to where she had less dice. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking I go into... I go into a quest as well. I could move, but it really is not going to secure me anything. So, let's see here. What do I feel like I have a chance against? I'd really love to do...
I was really hoping to get that extra juice and destroy a garrison.
I'm thinking I go for the druidic prophets.
Or okay, prophetess. So you do have to get 2 successes on that.
But a shield and a lightning bolt.
It's not impossible to get.
So a red, a magic, blue.
And then you get to choose.
Let's do the one that'll give me the chance of pulling
getting
that shield.
A shield. Yeah.
Nothing.
Three skull works.
Yeah, you have to get.
So you get 1 victory point. That's it.
And then chaos. Chaos gains 2.
Oh. So you get the 1 and chaos gains 2.
Am I anywhere? If I'm on a hex with a curse, I'm not.
Oh my god. What?
Discard.
The trial went so much better.
Oh, alright, Max.
Oh wait, what's this one? Every player gains 1 resource for each shield and lightning bolt you roll. I probably wouldn't have gone after that one. I would have gone after the other one.
I'm going for it. Okay. What else am I going to do? I don't have anyone here.
You got 3 actions left. You can move, explore.
She's going to kill my haven.
Mm-hmm.
So what do I do?
Yeah, she's going to move in there, man.
What do I do? What do I do?
This went so well
this
last time.
This went way better. I'm going to move there.
Like, to the point where I was like, oh, we've got chapter 1 without even considering it. Sean, where did we mess up? You've been watching.
What happened? The dice have been unkind.
But it's not just them. I think last time we dealt with smaller units.
It was different hordes. We had
one
different horde.
And we definitely didn't. I didn't face off against something that was grouped. Yeah. I walked into that not realizing the degree that little bit, that balance swing can have. Ooh. 4.
Dude, Maximus.
4.
4 salt.
Salt's not bad.
4 salt's nice.
20 skeletons?
Yeah. Uh-huh. That's it for me for that turn.
I'm going to go to the market.
What are you buying?
I'm going to spend a salt to purchase.
I need to look at the market too, man.
The Ixrit leaves. Discard this to add any 1 die to any of your rolls outside of combat before rolling.
Okay.
What else is up there, Sean? Did it look appealing to anybody?
Well, 1 salt for a healing potion.
Okay.
Brings back someone that died to one of your havens. The leeching orb, remove a curse and any hex and gain 1 victory point. That's pretty powerful, but it costs 4 salt. And you've got 4 salt.
Remove 1 curse in any hex and gain 1 victory point. But curses... That's a lot to give up. That's a lot of salt. I mean, that's a troll that I can
You're
spot.
Taking a victory point away from them, though, because they score a point for every curse on the board.
Curses are big.
So it's a victory point swing, basically. Yeah. 2 victory points for
Well, it's
for
a perpetual victory point for them if we don't ever remove
it. It's
them.
True, and it's also... That's a card that goes into your deck, right?
Is it a discard after use, though?
Let me see.
Discard.
No, it's...
It is a discard after use, yep.
Oh, it's an immediate, so right when you get
you
it,
do it immediately.
You do it. Okay.
Now, how else do you get rid of hexes? Curses. Should I say?
A lot of it's going to be magic. There could be some quests that do it as well.
So,
I think that's pretty big if you've got the 4 salt in there.
I do, but this would be my last action, and I think I can probably complete that quest. Oh, and by... Yeah, I need the salt for my units. Yeah, I'm not doing either of those.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and try and complete this quest, I think.
Going for this one here?
Yep.
I didn't gain my 2 plunder when I flipped that because I should have
sure.
3.
Give me a purple die, please, sir.
At this point, you could say, look, I didn't gain the 7 extra units that I'm supposed to. And be like, yeah.
Well, the reason
sounds
I...
Sounds right.
Did I build a second haven? Oh, I did build the second haven. See, that's the easy way I knew. Like, I just... I
you knew exactly what you had, yeah.
My hero was there.
Ooh.
3 doesn't do it, but I could complete both of these.
Yep.
We may draw a new quest, okay. Which isn't going to matter. No one
no,
has any.
Get,
oh, Sean,
oh,
you have
actions.
One.
Oh, nice.
We may discard any items from the market. Anything worth discarding?
Do they refill right now? Because they're going to all discard at the end. It says draw one, if empty, draw an item.
So then you're supposed to draw
oh, yeah,
one and fill that
refill.
That is the Axe of the Giants. Pay a food to gain a hit.
But you need three strength.
You have to have three strength
that.
Or yeah, have the ability to always get stuff.
Oh, so you could.
But you have to have four salt. Oh, man, that's going to go away at the end of the round, too.
Each player gains one resource for each lightning and shield you rolled, so two.
Two resources of our choice.
Seems like it.
Now, we can always, by the way, trade three resources for one, by the way. There's
I'm going to go ahead and get a third one of these.
There's always that conversion.
Ooh, I might.
I have to build a haven.
I get two salts.
Taking two plunder.
So I'm going to take a third. Yeah, I had to take one plunder so I can build another haven. And then I'm going to take one food.
Okay. I'm out of actions.
What is the likelihood of moving and exploring and something not spawning onto that hex?
It seems very unlikely.
I think low.
I think every time something gets spawned.
I think most of the times when you're exploring a thing, you have to deal with... Now, some of the spires and things, I think, have positive results.
I mean, this said remove any garrison. There just didn't have to be a garrison there.
That's true.
Okay. So, what is this quest that we just got? Strike at Dawn. You may draw a new quest, and if I solve it, one Legion or Horde loses two threat.
Ooh.
That would take this girl down to one.
Ooh.
So then she'd be back up to three.
But she's going
to
go back up to three instead of
going
up
to
five.
Yeah.
But if I fail,
it might make her more manageable.
It activates a legion immediately.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big.
We don't have a legion. What's legion?
Legions are those guys or hordes. It's legion or horde.
We wouldn't have a legion to activate though. So the fail is
legion or a horde. So if I fail, one of those guys.
One of those will. We have to choose which one is going to activate.
Oh, or horde. Okay, got it.
I'm going to risk it.
Wow, this could go so poor.
This could be the epic ending to chapter 1.
Now, do you
one.
Get that extra dice? I don't know. Just make sure.
So, if your hero is on a hex with a legion or a horde, plus one, no, because I'm not there. So, I get my red, I get my purple, I get a white, and an orange. I'm looking for four hits, a shield, or a bolt. And I only need one success.
Now, you could do two whites for a greater chance at shield.
I could.
Mm-hmm.
So do you want me to do that instead of the
Well, you only need one success, and that's the only one that gives you an actual boon. I think that's the best thing to go for.
But remember, we both died and we both got entirely wiped by...
Yeah.
So. If I fail, it's Max's fault.
That's fair.
No.
We did establish that at the very beginning. If we lose...
Do I want to use these leaves to get an extra die to guarantee this?
I think you've got it. Okay. I mean, one shield.
Oh my gosh. Max...
Yeah,
matter.
Stop.
Activate a legion. Or a horde.
Are you effing kidding me?
How does the activation phase work? Let's pull that up.
Oh, it's nasty. Activating a horde.
That one's coming to you or this one's coming to me. It doesn't matter.
Follow these steps in order.
I shouldn't have built right next to him.
So which horde...
Me too. What are we doing? Our trial run went...
Which horde do we... Do we activate
so
the Lich Queen because it's got the lower number?
No, the Counter of
could
Omens
be,
has lower number.
Could be either, yeah.
Okay, it has 24 and the other one has 20.
I meant, like, threat level.
Oh, I was talking about
initiative. Yeah, you're talking about the top number. I think we get to choose in this situation.
Initiative.
But they activate
I
in
I think they
order.
Activate by initiative.
So. They do when they all activate.
Oh.
But in this case, if we're just activating one, it's telling us to...
But isn't it going to use our activation token as well? Because we're
no,
activating it.
I don't believe so. I believe it... Does one activation.
I think it activates without the token
yeah,
as well.
I think it just does. Because you
all
remember,
right.
You can add additional activations to them.
So place a curse here or chaos gains one victory point if there's already a curse in that hex. So we would place the curse up there with the Counter of Omens.
Yeah, activate mine. Move that up there. Let's be honest, I deserve it.
Move the horde one hex, not farther from the capital. So it has to move in towards the capital.
Mm-hmm.
So
into a haven if possible, right?
Which it's going to do.
Hexes are, should remember, hordes cannot pass through impassable terrain while moving. Use this priority into a haven. Hordes always choose a haven over another hex. If it moves into a haven...
There's no way.
If there are enemy units in player or empire... Combat ability, so we have to have combat. Does your haven give you any without a tower or a wall? It's just a haven, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is ugly.
This is, I mean, there's no way we come back. Our trial run was so much better.
Yeah.
I'm glad that it's very different, though. But, wow, we were so overly confident.
All right, so is it back to me to screw something else up?
This, to be fair, this is what I like a cooperative game to
me
be.
Me too, I like difficult games. I think like, if you win every game, there's no point in playing. That's why one of my favorite games is Spirit Island. But...
And the chaos management and spirit, like, this is like a high fantasy post-apocalyptic Spirit Island for me.
The problem is that we were just very caught off guard. I should have not gambled. I really wanted to because I thought yours was a fluke.
I think this, from what I'm getting, I feel like this might be one of those games where you don't gamble.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you want to play it a little conservative to start.
I just didn't want her to level up, but oh my gosh.
Having your hero on a different hex isn't really going to help. To the start of the next round.
That's right. That's why I went ahead and you could grain some more salt if you want to go ahead and buy some. You could go ahead and purchase an item if possible.
I guess I'll buy the healer.
You could do a move because then that's one activation you don't have to spend to reveal.
Yeah, I mean the moving is one thing
I'll
you don't have to do.
Go ahead and move here.
Do it.
Okay.
Start the next round. All right. So that was my
move. All right. Cycle it down. We're all out of. Wow.
Wow. All
right. Nemesis phase. Activate Legions and Hordes once for each activation token on them in numerical order. So we start with the
22, Lich. The Lich Queen.
So it's going to go to the purple.
So again,
right?
Place a curse there. If there is a one there, they get a victory point. No, we're at the Lich
curse,
Queen right now.
Curse here, they're going to gain one victory
point. So they get a victory point. Mm-hmm. Then we move the Horde. One
they don't place
in.
This yet, though, do they? Do they place it when they arrive as well, or no?
No.
Okay.
They just, that's the initial game victory. Now we move the Horde one hex in.
We did it.
If it can into a haven, if it can into a hex with enemy units, so it's actually going to move towards his, does his hero count?
She moved into a haven and destroyed the haven.
Oh,
haven,
there was a haven there.
Haven's okay. Always the first pick. And my second haven's destroyed.
Well, it moves in closer towards the capital.
It doesn't have to be closer, it just cannot be farther away.
Oh, sure.
And havens are always priority.
Right, and it's still
true.
Just one away.
Mm-hmm.
Ouch. Wow.
All right, now we go on to the production phase.
Wow.
Gain resources based on your total havens.
Oh my gosh.
How's that going for you?
This is
going
to be an epic bounce back. This story will be told by bards forever.
I'm hopeful. John.
What? Bards are not going to be alive forever. This is the end of humanity.
No, we're bringing it back.
There's one in the middle of a snowstorm. The last remaining person is a bard telling this story. And 'twas the night he stormed the keep.
Yeah, we effed up.
And then we gain resources
the
shown
counter of all
on the hexes. So gain resources on your hexes.
And hey, I pray for
how many resources are you getting, Jesse?
I got 3.
2 plunder. Assault.
Christ.
A plunder.
That's not how you want this turn to go.
I can't even stack these. I'm laughing. Wow.
Then we go to the scoring phase.
Mm-hmm.
The Empire scores a point for the capital, so they're going to get one there. A point for each hex with a garrison. So they'll
4.
Get that puts them at 4. 1 point for each legion is 0. Mm-hmm. And 2 points for each faction in their graveyard. So
1.
They're just going to get 2. That's me.
2, yeah.
Chaos gets 1 for each curse.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I think Chaos is kicking her butt.
Yeah.
1 for each horde. So they get
2
more.
And two for each
faction in their
4.
Graveyard. So another 4. Return all units from the graveyard to the players. Now the players score.
We let chaos run amok.
They wrecked us. Alright, players score 2 for each of their havens. 1, and then for any special points on the board. And 1 if you pay 5 resources.
So I get 3 points.
I get 5.
How many you get, Jesse? You get 1.
Chaos already rounded the bend up there.
Wait, why'd you just put him up?
That was me.
Because he gets 5.
Yeah.
You already moved him 5, did you not?
Moved him 3.
Chaos, buddy.
Yeah, he needs to slow down.
So this is a wash.
Well,
we're going to try our hardest.
He got the 5 to start, and then we
fed him. I mean, we literally inted. This is like where you just walk in like, hey, buddy.
So did you went first, so now Max will be first player. We're in the refresh phase. If you have to flip any cards, flip those back
up.
Get your action points back. Discard market items. Draw new ones.
Wow.
This is the worst part
I've I'm going to be doing a solo gameplay of this.
There's no way it can go this bad. This has been terrible.
Discard quest.
It makes me like the game more.
I mean, I am glad that it is, you know, we like you said, it's we were brutal. Overconfident. We were overconfident. Yeah.
The rule book says expect to lose.
Which is cool. Sure. I want, in a game like this, I don't want to expect to win.
All right. Yeah.
But.
Because when you do.
How did the trial run? Were we playing a rule wrong?
No.
We just rolled that well?
I don't think it was the rolls. We didn't, our mathematics when we did our encounters.
We were a little
too
aggressive.
We were a little overconfident. Because last time we were facing 2-3 skeletons at a time. And then we buffed up and took out one of these instead of two of us.
But we didn't buff. How did we buff?
I did. Remember, I had the card.
One of his young ones became a.
I didn't buff myself at all.
But you didn't face anyone other than skeletons last time.
No, I faced the.
You didn't face the worm.
I don't think you went.
You
after
decided not to go after it because of how strong it was. And I had the card that got an oath sworn out here.
Huh.
So we buffed just a little bit, and that was enough.
Yeah, and here comes the good news.
And this time...
What's the good news, Sean?
Both of those threat levels increased by 2.
Thank you for the good news, Sean.
Yeah. Thanks for the good news, Sean.
Oh, and here's the extra good news. Next event.
Mm. Oh, the next my chapter. God.
All right, this is the Unholy Omens.
Yes, it is.
Fishermen...
That fits the counter of omens so well.
Fishermen and sailors began to drill deep holes in the frozen sea to fish, but most of them do not return these days. In their place... Unearthly screams wafted through the icy wasteland. Place 2 skeletons on 1 unexplored, empty hex.
I'm just imagining these dead vocal cord screams just echoing across the barren plain.
I'm so scared.
And huge flocks of birds coming from the ruined mainland are heading west across the islands of Azul. Their echoing cries in the sky fill the survivors with a dark foreboding.
Mm-hmm.
Place 1 legion at threat level 4... on the capital.
Okay. Who is this? Who is this?
The Warlock.
The Warlock.
Threat level 4, immediate. Place his target. Every player... What does place his target mean first?
Hold on, let me... Fine.
Every player pays 1 salt for each of their havens. Fortunately for me, it's only 1 salt.
Well, I don't have to spend any salt.
What is his target?
So, when you place a target, legions come out of the capital with a specific goal, right? They're going to be hunting a haven that currently is undefended, or at least the least defended. So we choose a player, and then we choose a haven that has as little going on as possible.
I'd love to choose you, Jesse.
I don't have any havens left, and
you're coming
only,
after me.
It's got to be
one.
You. It says
it
the
can't
one,
be me.
It targets the least defended.
Least defended. Oh, it could
yours
be him.
Yours is least defended
okay.
too.
Send them my way.
Sure,
I'll take them.
I think that we should. Work on maybe trying to get us all back up to par.
Bring it. Bring it, Legion. What is his name?
The Warlock.
The Warlock?
Yeah.
Come on over. I shouldn't say that.
You know, since we're never going to get to experience it, I just have to show people how... This is a prototype. Look, a wall...
It's pretty awesome how they build.
And a garrison.
And tower.
And then the garrison...
Show the garrison
and then
levels
the garrisons
up.
Can build up to level 2.
2. Well, we'll probably see that happen, to
that's
be fair.
Accurate.
And then level 3.
It's actually so cool.
So cool.
Now we need to place 1 horde at threat level 4 on MP Hex, so we are getting an additional horde.
We're going to run out of space. Oh my god.
Who do you pull?
The Stormbringer.
Ooh, I like it. Look at that. It's just a... It's literally...
It's just pulling everything as it comes across the land.
It's just a ball of human bones.
Where's he go?
On any empty hex.
Okay, keep in mind he's immediately activating.
No, you're first player. You get to choose what happens where.
Well, I mean, he's definitely going over there somewhere where he can't immediately hit a freaking place.
On any empty hex, and he's immediately activating, so...
Why don't you move him one farther?
Wait, how is he activating?
Immediately. Activate the Stormbringer. You do not need a token.
So he moves in towards the capital city, moving
what threat
towards
level
havens.
Is this guy at? Midnight?
So he would come here.
What threat level is he at?
4.
Midnight?
Yeah, exactly.
Threat level midnight?
Threat level, we're dead. Alright, and last but not least, flip 1 unexplored hex and resolve its effects.
Gain 2 salt. Is anybody gaining 2 salt?
I think you get it, your first player. I don't know.
That'd be cool, I'll take it. If empty, place 2 skeletons here.
Awesome! I've played... This is the third time I've played.
This is scary.
This is the worst.
This has to be.
It's the worst I've ever. We were way too confident. All right, what's going on?
All right, now we put an activation token on each of those chiefs.
Now those are
those carried from those, the last. No, those were from the last round. They didn't get removed when they activated. But don't forget the warlock. And now we get to build again. So we draw two feats. Choose one. Discard the other.
Oh my gosh!
All right, I'm using this one for sure.
Oh, blessed love.
I immediately gain any three resources, FYI.
Yeah, I've got to take this one. Ashay Force, always reduce the cost of younglings to one. We're getting five younglings out on the board, because...
I will be able to complete one quest guaranteed. I have informants. Discard this when you use the quest action. Turn the dice to any sides you want.
Oh, nice.
So we're going to get a good quest completion this round. See, I told you the tides were going to turn.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If they somehow successfully turn.
And then now after we've done our feats, we build units, towers, walls, or any on any of our havens.
I'm spending five of these immediately. I really should keep two, though. Do I get five people out and hope that I can gain plunder? Or do I save two... I think I get five out and hope I can get plunder.
Yeah, you got to.
Because I can at least build a haven. Well,
got to, man.
I also need a haven down, though. I really desperately need a haven.
We really desperately messed up hugely.
Give me two back. Give me two back. I'm going to put three out. I'm going to save two for that haven. I'm going to have to spend some resource... Spend four action?
Four action?
I'm going to spend two action to get one more area down. I got four people on the board. Actually, let me only spend one action. No, it'll still be two action. Let me spend one more of these, because I know I'm going to get a plunder from that.
Now, do these spawn on your haven or on your hero?
I don't have a haven.
So they spawn on your hero?
On me. Yeah.
So what about me? Would they spawn here or here?
They would spawn in your
haven. They'd spawn in my haven.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get some single plunders?
Sure thing, buddy. One. How many?
Three, please.
Two. Three.
Gracias.
You're welcome, sir.
All right, so I'm going to put an elite archer out. I'm not going to play around with this warlock.
Don't, because they...
No, it's I'm going to town on that
They're floor. Not friendly.
No, he's not going to live.
I thought they might be.
No. And then I'm going to put a basic archer there with that elite archer.
The other cool thing is they were... All these custom stands we have, like the shapes they have, when they were first playing with like the acrylic slide-in standy bases type of things, they quickly discovered that it was really annoying to have things tip over all the time.
Mm.
So they did custom molded bases.
Yeah, I like them.
Specifically to prevent falling over. And that'll be this in the official game as well. Like these... With just a little bit more to create, you know, to create tension from falling. You see that?
All right, so that's what I'm putting out on the board.
I don't... Okay.
Everybody done building?
I am. Action. What'd you end up getting?
I built my troll and a warg.
Just two?
Yeah, but I'm about to get one basic unit for every legion and horde.
Okay.
Bring the house.
No, that's up to five though, right?
Up to five in a space, yes.
In a space, yeah.
So that's a max of three right now.
Correct.
I really want to build another haven before I...
Don't die.
Because then I could spawn way more than three. I could spawn eight.
It's your turn, Chieftain.
Yeah, it's all you.
Shit.
All I know is that warlock is dead.
Is he?
The other thing is if we can get them to run into each other, they'll...
They do fight each other,
too.
But we don't want to let them get any more victory points because they have already ran away with the game.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't mind letting the Empire kill some chaos, but the chaos definitely cannot beat any.
Yeah. What are you thinking?
Jesus. Jeez Louise. God, I don't know. I could go there and flip, or I could go here and flip.
That's a long move.
I know, that's what I'm saying. But I need to build. Wait, what does this thing let me do?
Oh, that'll put you adjacent
to heroes here, adjacent to any hex. If your heroes here, pay one less for items on the market. Any items on the market I need?
Let's see.
I only have one salt anyway.
Did we refresh the whole market?
We did refresh.
Okay.
Is there anything worth one or two salt?
Well, you can buy it one less, right?
Yeah.
So this is one less salt. It would be one salt for you. Place one tower and one wall on any haven. Every other player may place one tower on any haven. Discard this. You have to have one blue on your hero, which you
do.
Got.
Yeah.
This one is Imperial Defectors. Every player places one basic unit of any of their havens on any of their havens. You have to have one green to get that one, which you don't have.
Yeah, I do.
Because of that card down there?
Yeah, one dial.
Oh, nice. And then the other one costs three salt.
How much do the other two cost?
It's one, two, and three.
So I can get the one for free, right?
Does it restrict to say to a minimum
pay of one? Pay one less for items on the market.
It doesn't say to a minimum of one. Normally games say that.
Mm-hmm. So which one is that?
That's the one that lets us place one basic unit on any of our havens and discard.
So every player plays one basic unit on any of their havens. So, bam.
You do have to take an activation to purchase on the market.
Yeah, you gotta go market.
Which I'm gonna go ahead and move before I do that real quick. Okay. I'm adjacent to any hex, right?
Well, I think your hero has to be there to do that.
Right. This is my hero. She's here.
So then you can't move and then
complete. No, she could. Your turn would end. It's his turn.
Then you can move next. I move next turn. Yeah. Got it. I got it.
That's what you're saying.
I can't use the market because I would have left. I got it. Exactly. Yep, I got it.
All right. What are you thinking, Sean?
Did you all place your basic?
Yes, mm-hmm. I put an archer in here. I'm going to reveal.
I didn't have a haven to put a basic down on.
You stink.
I'm going to explore. And I reveal.
I shouldn't have built in the direction of.
I mean, I did the same thing. We all messed up.
Well, and they activated twice, so.
We all messed up.
I revealed Dunkel Home. Gain 2 plunder. Remove any skeletons here. Place 2 garrisons here.
Two. It's and a it level 3 garrison. One. Yeah, it's a level 3 garrison.
Yeah, that's not bueno.
This
Each player draws 1 feat, then discards 1 feat.
Okay, well, that's good.
You're gonna get another card now. Holy crow.
So I'm getting rid of my elephant card. So I'm gaining archery. Ignore one hit or one shield on your enemy's dice before damage once per round on your hero's hex. So, just a little bit of mediation there.
I didn't keep what I got, I just put it right back in. This is absurd.
I got a card that makes all items in the market cost one less salt. Mm-hmm. And then when I discard an item, I also gain a salt.
You do need to refill that, by the way.
Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm. Orb of Storms. Move one horde or legion to an adjacent hex without activating it.
Okay.
So you could cause it to attack another person or something.
All right. Down onto me. I'm going to go ahead and just establish the haven. I can't. I didn't save 2.
You haven't moved yet either.
I'm there. I could establish.
Oh, yeah, you don't have one. Yeah.
Now do I try to kill the Omen girl?
I mean, she is by herself.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think I do, though.
I think you have to.
I don't think I do.
I don't think you do either. No, she'd kill you. She'd wipe you. Can you move out and take off that skeleton and that omen? I mean, the curse, maybe?
No, this is bad news. I need to move into this location where there's plunder, so I'm going to start with a new action. Why?
Oh, you can. Your hero can.
Yeah, I can. Troll Ward. Gain 2. Good.
That's good for you.
I did need that.
2 garrisons, though.
Up to 3.
Oh, but it's not empty.
If empty, place 2 garrisons here.
It's
it
not
was,
empty.
Oh, it wasn't. Yep. If not, reinforced, so 1 will be added.
I need to flip. I forgot about the
opposition.
And place 1 on the one with the least token, so we get to choose which one we want to put it on.
Place 1 activation token on the one with...
The weakest? I mean, either the Warlock or the Stormbringer. Just put another one on the Warlock, because we think he can maybe die quicker. Good call.
Yeah.
I don't know what we're doing, Sean. I don't think there's any hope here.
There's hope.
All right, so I moved in.
Hope is lost.
On to you.
It's pretty ugly, but there's hope. There's always hope.
Hope is lost.
On to you.
What do I do?
Everything.
I mean, I do have a red, a black, and a white right there. I could spawn more. I don't want to spawn more, though. I really want to use this bonfires card. But I need a new haven before I can do that.
You can move through, get to a point where you could establish a haven. You could push in with... I mean, you could try to push up, or...
I mean, I can move anywhere I want, because I'm adjacent.
Yeah, so...
So I can go here?
You need to move into a zone that's cleared, though. Why don't you pop to where my guys are and put a haven right there?
Because then I couldn't put anybody there.
But I'm moving out next turn. You could do it next turn.
When he moves out.
Because I'm migrating. I'm going to go deal with this next turn. Okay. And that's going to be empty for you.
All right, let's do it.
Use your activation. You
planning like we're playing a cooperative game.
Like we're supposed to work together.
What? The rulebook actually suggests to take 5 minutes in between rounds and kind of plan your strategy for the next round.
So I'm going to go ahead and place my haven there.
Well, you can't. I don't think you can do it while he's there.
Couldn't say I can't.
He can, yeah.
It says if there's no cursed enemy unit, haven, or X in the explorer
yep.
X.
Yeah, you can put it down.
As long as it's, yeah. Cool.
Now, does that cost an action too, right?
It does.
It does.
So you're moving onto you.
So onto me. I think I'm going to try to, I'm going to do command, pay a food, and I'm going to try to take out this level 3 garrison.
Okay.
All 5 of those guys are going to go in there.
So you got orange, white, purple, orange, and white.
They've got 3 white to start for ranged.
So I have a purple and a white for my first range.
Okay.
What'd you say they get?
3 white.
Nothing?
Thank you,
take them out.
Now
hit them.
I need to...
Hit them 3.
Hit them hard, buddy.
Son of a...
One.
Hey.
Biscuit.
Hey.
It's 1. Hey, it's something.
I'll keep it here so we remember like we did last time. So that's
now we're
point.
Doing
white, orange, orange, blue.
So now we're all in. So I got
orange, orange, white, white, purple.
So I get my purple and white.
So grab 2 oranges as well.
Don't I have 2 oranges?
Yep, this is orange, orange.
Need 1 more orange.
There we are. All right, roll first. It's okay.
Hits,
it's
hits.
Okay.
Not the worst. It could be way
clean
worse.
Through clean through it. Get some shields.
So we are in the clash round, so I'm still going to roll, but before damage, I get to...
You don't have any salt.
Ah! Except for during the actions phase,
You could always use a...
Well, I can flip this to get... I've got 3 orange on the board, right?
So yeah,
I get 3 salt.
Go ahead.
Because it says during the actions phase, so that gets me 3 salt.
Perfect.
And then now I will be able to...
And that was what, 2 skulls I rolled?
Yeah, you got 2 hits. 2 bolts.
2 bolts.
So is that only the current one?
Archery
there?
And clash. Place your cheapest unit in the resources from the graveyard on any explored hex without an enemy.
Matter.
Are they hitting you though?
You hit me twice and I got no blocks.
So
yeah.
Damage simultaneous?
After damage, once per round. You could do this at least once. So one would be hit and one would be summoned back.
Okay.
But it would be summoned back onto a... So here's the question.
Any explored hex without enemy units.
So right next to you, but...
Or I could just put it back here with these guys, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. They just couldn't be engaged in the same battle.
So I'm going to kill an archer and a spearman.
And who do you want to bring
back? I'm bringing back the archers. They're more expensive.
And then you could gain 1 resource as well if you'd like.
Oh, so both of these, because they're both available
well,
to
got,
be triggered?
You got 2 lightning bolts, so you can
so
trigger
you
both.
Gain, do you gain 2? Then is that considered 1 resource?
No.
You just gain 1.
So 1 of those.
One plunder.
Okay. Back to the battle. You're gonna have a purple.
So
orange
I didn't
and
even
white.
Need to spend this though. Like I thought, or did I? No. Yeah, because I needed 2 hits. So I do need to spend this to make it an automatic hit.
Yes.
So that's my 2 hits.
So he's dead.
Oh, you wiped him.
Yeah.
So no more battles.
I've got 1 hit, and then I use my assassin to do the final.
Perfect.
Cool.
So that gets me 3 victory points.
Oh.
That's something.
Blue.
White.
Or white. Sorry.
He's white.
Thank you.
Okay.
Alright.
Well, back to me.
You're commanding, right?
I am.
Okay.
Spending a food.
I can bring him back exactly where he was. It just says any explored hex without
right,
any
units. Right,
after
damage. Now he could go there. We didn't realize that he was going to be wiped yet.
Oh, I knew he was going to be
okay.
wiped.
Okay, that's what we weren't sure of. Now they can't move there, can they?
Yeah.
Why couldn't they?
Because of the...
Impassable terrain.
Yeah.
The way that hex is turned.
Is that what you were saying before?
Yeah. But your hero can do it. They can't.
So what you're saying is he should have revealed
that tile? You
have
to go there first.
I needed the plunder, though.
Oh, so you can't move this time.
Well, he's got to move another turn. It's going to take another two turns.
You son of a...
Do it. You got to do it. Take your turns.
Or you could... command...
I warned you about that. I just want you to know. I said it.
So this will give people a feel of how you shouldn't play
the right game.
Play smart.
Yeah, we just
talk about your turns.
We went so balls deep early on that really just messed up.
Oh, I like it.
You're going
like
for it.
It.
Let's
do it.
It's happening.
Let's do it.
Oh my God. No, dude, no.
Oh, four. What is his threat level?
He gets four white.
That's all right.
What do you get for range?
I'm gonna murder him.
What do you get for range?
I get nothing for
range. He gets four white.
I get one white for range.
He gets four white?
Are you kidding me, Jesse?
Two shield and a hit.
Alright, nothing happens in range.
It's cocked. Nothing. Roll it again. It's cocked.
That's true. It's true.
Okay.
Still cocked. and I could spend this to ignore. So I'll do that.
Okay, so nothing happened.
Nobody got killed. It was a wash.
Oh my God. Why did you do that?
What's his power?
Five.
No, but what's he rolling?
Oh, purple, purple, blue, blue, orange.
Purple, purple.
Blue, blue, orange.
Blue, blue.
Orange.
Orange.
Jesse, why did you do this? You didn't learn your lesson?
Three hits and a shield.
Okay, that's actually pretty good. Okay, not nearly.
Four hits and a lightning bolt.
Wait, who hits first, though? They don't have any shields.
We each hit each other.
At the same time?
Yeah.
You don't drop down there? Well, no, you wouldn't. You wouldn't drop them down. So you dropped him down from 5 to 2, right?
He hit him. Is that what you rolled?
No, no. I rolled
it was three hits and a shield.
5 to 2.
So you nullify one of these with the shield.
Three hits are coming across to
and
me.
And his bolt ability.
And place two lightning their skeletons on an empty hex.
So two skeletons popping down. We're going again, though.
Hey, what if we... Hey, we don't have any more skeletons after this.
Well, I then think no they more get victory points for everyone
they
that
do
couldn't be placed.
For can't summon. Hey, I'm going again. What's his...
What's his level now? Dice rolling?
Blue, blue, orange.
Okay, and I'm blue, blue.
Oh my God.
Nice.
Two hits. Two hits and a shield.
So one hit.
Down to one.
You don't have anything else?
No.
Why did you do it, Jesse?
Because I was close.
Why did you do it, Jesse?
Because I want to give the people a show.
You just spent all that time.
I want to give the people a
the
show.
The people have had a show. The show now would be if we can make a comeback.
I thought I could take him out.
The show now is can we come back
if
from
I
this disastrous beginning.
If I could have taken him out, maybe.
It would have been cool.
It would have been a thing.
You know what? Winning the lottery is cool too, Jesse. The odds were not in your favor. Oh,
I was gonna move in there, but apparently I built the thing.
Hey man, where'd your people go, bro?
All right,
Max, your turn.
All right, I'm discarding this card.
What's it let you do?
Gain one basic unit on any haven for every Horde and Legion on the map.
And now you
one,
can go
two,
kill him.
One, two, three, four. Four?
There's four. There's
one,
four
two,
cards
three,
over
four.
There.
Okay. Two archers.
Why don't you put them up there and go kill that guy? He's got one hit left.
And then
is it any one haven or can you split them?
I can split them, I think.
So you could put a couple
on any of your havens.
Yeah, so put a couple up there, a couple down here.
I set Max up to take out...
It's a co-op!
So, that didn't count as an action, right?
I don't think so. There's not an action space for that.
So
Max, you take
command?
Out the queen.
Yeah, I'm going.
I move there and then I build a haven.
I'm going. These guys are going. Can they do it? Hold on. Two white? It's two white versus two white.
You got it.
You got
Wait,
it.
Wait, no, hold on.
Got,
let me just be
no,
safe.
No, don't guarantee it. Kill this one, too. Kill the Eldritch Queen.
Two white versus two white.
You got this. I'll roll for them. You roll for yourself.
Are you kidding me?
Got this. Ready to go? One hit. That's it. All you need is one.
And you blocked it!
Get out of here.
Good teamwork.
If destroyed... Place two skeletons here.
So they get two victory points.
But it's still open for you to come into next round. They get victory points, but it's open.
Oh, great.
So give them two more victory points.
How many victory points do you get for doing
two.
That, though?
For killing him, you only get two?
Two.
For killing a Horde, you get two?
Two.
All right.
I would give you 3 at least.
Thanks, babe.
a mess.
That's all we got quest.
At least we wiped one. I mean, it wiped you too.
I did set you up for that, though, and now you might be able to kill the Lich Queen.
I'm hoping a troll and one of these guys, an archer and 2 normals? Come on, man.
You should be able to. Mm. And we have to deal with them. Like, we have.
She's got purple, red, orange.
She only gets stronger.
If you can only get one stronger.
And then what happens? We lose.
Oh, she can only get one stronger.
To be fair, I was close to taking that one out on my own.
I knew you shouldn't have done it, though.
What would you have done?
I would have moved here, man.
Yeah?
With your guy.
I don't like our quest. I want a quest.
You don't like any of them?
I mean, I felt like I need to do other stuff and things, though.
Okay. A bunch of stuff
and things,
man.
Is that impossible that way?
It's not.
So I can go after the Lich Queen.
Oh. Tandem. Knock him down.
You want me to soften her up for you?
Get a little 1-2. I'll come in there behind with my ogre and just... It'll be a good time.
Okay.
You're going to wipe, though, by the way. I just want you to know that.
If you went there, you'd wipe.
There's no way you don't wipe if
she's
you go there
way
by
too
yourself.
Beefy.
You think so?
Four people.
I think he's in a better position to take her on than you are.
I mean, he does have one of his purple, though.
You could just start clearing skeletons, though, to prevent them
Wait,
from scoring straight
points. Purple's
straight
better than black,
points.
According to this. So, I mean...
Purple what?
Purple's better than black, according to this.
Yeah, because it trades a... No, it trades a black for a purple.
Right.
So black's better than purple.
But it never trades black.
Yeah, it goes black purple, and then it goes black purple.
Right. So it trades black, it adds black.
2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 3 plus 4.
A purple upgrades to a black, so black is better than purple.
Purple doesn't upgrade to a black; it just gives you another black. Purple stays. It goes by order of strength, right, from left to right.
Yeah.
So black, then purple, then red.
Black, no. Because white is weaker.
This is an entertaining
black is stronger.
Than white? Yes. Then
black
purple,
is stronger
no.
than purple.
No,
yes.
It's not.
Yes, it is.
How?
Because can I see the black dice and the purple dice?
It says it goes left to right.
The black has 3 skulls
black
on it.
Black is stronger than purple. Do you see 3 skulls anywhere else on anything else?
It has no blanks on black.
Okay, black is stronger than purple.
All right.
There's no blanks on the black.
Clarify
this
that.
This thing does 1 black
I think
every
he has a whole
range.
Full set of baseball.
Stop. I'm going to take home some game for that tonight.
What are we thinking?
All right. If your hero is on a marsh, X plus 1.
My neck's hurting, too.
So should I go after the warlock, then? And go into this capital? Should I wreck the capital?
I don't think you can beat either of them.
I think maybe you start clearing skeletons and opening up land.
Well, I can't go that way because it's impossible.
Oh. You can't go that way either,
though. You can't go that way towards the warlock either.
So here's the thing. How do we remove the Lich Queen? Other than sacrifice units.
We kill her.
So you need to go sacrifice yourself then, and then I'll try and kill her.
I might be able to take her on your own.
I don't think I can.
Command.
I'm going to be honest. I've never dealt with people like the Lich Queen before.
Okay.
She's so strong.
In range. I've
never successfully killed them.
In range, I get a purple and a white. What do you get?
3 whites.
3 whites? You got 3.
2 skulls and a shield. Not a great start.
A terrible start.
Could be worse.
2 hits.
Okay.
So I take her down 1.
You're being hit twice.
Skadoosh. Oh, I should have rolled 2 whites. I forgot I had 2 archers.
Oh, roll another white then. Could be a shield. Could be another hit. Hey, so only 1 guy dies.
1 person.
So I
don't forget you have a lightning too.
Well, no, that just
oh,
it just got
oh, okay, just kidding, just kidding, just kidding,
just kidding. I won't do that.
So
you're gonna remove your orange, right?
Well, yeah, because I want.
I mean, you would have to. The whites do white and range. I mean, there's no reason not to.
So now we're moving on to the next stage.
Purple, red, orange, white. Here's a white.
Before damage, I would have paid a salt to do an extra damage. So drop it down 1 more before you get those dice.
Oh, you need...
Because I'm using this ability.
You need a purple. That's it. Purple, orange, white.
Purple, orange. How did she get so many freaking dice?
I don't know, man.
That's at level 4?
Yeah, she's busted.
Holy crow.
That's not bad.
Two hits.
Two and one. That's the same as archery. We're good.
That's not bad. Two hits and a shield.
Oh my gosh!
That's pretty awful.
Are you freaking kidding me?
That's pretty bad.
That's ridiculous!
So what, are you losing both your archers, I
guess? What is the sticker doing on that? That shouldn't be there.
Just do what you do to fix a Rubik's Cube. Just re-sticker
the sides. Well, I'm going to pay another salt to at least knock her down another tier.
Okay, I mean, that's something.
Okay, what should go down to now?
Three. Purple, orange, white.
Did say you'd wipe on her.
Yeah, we said you would wipe. I mean,
this, remember, this is part of the plan. This was part of the plan.
Wait,
I wouldn't roll three blanks. I didn't see that one coming.
I didn't either.
I guess the five blanks I rolled in test game should have told me something. What is
two hits? Two hits, shield and lightning bolt.
What's her bolt do?
Every horde in play gains one threat, including her.
Oh, stop.
Before damage.
No.
We played this so bad.
No. No, Max.
At least I wiped the one before this happened.
How many hits did you have? Two hits?
It was
two hits.
I got him right here. Where that went. Two hits and a shield.
That is the suckiest elite archer in the history. There is one blank. One blank on that die. One blank.
I rolled it twice.
And I rolled it twice.
There you go.
Three times out of four.
It's weighted, dude.
Your turn, Jesse.
The good news.
It's very difficult.
Is
there's not much.
So I'm gonna move twice. Into here.
Oh, I could have done that.
Done what?
I could have moved in these troops to beef up the attack.
No, you would have had to do a command, multiple commands.
Oh, move your hero.
Yeah, move my hero. Yeah. Okay.
And now I'm establishing a haven, my first haven of the game. First haven of the game, good news. We are on the map again, back basically. I retreated back to my home and went, it was bad out there. It's real bad. No, trust me, I'd rather just be here for the, we're dead. But we'll spend a few months with my family.
Oh my god.
So that's gonna end my. I've got one action left. It's down to you.
I've got five actions, but.
I feel like crying.
We were so confident.
We were too confident.
I did not see that going that way.
I mean, how we. By the end of the demo, we all had, two havens on the board, had scored an equivalent amount of victory points across the board, had the game state was fairly balanced. I think there was one creature left, one chaos creature left for us to fight. And then we turn on the cameras and we decide, for some reason, to Hail Mary it and get slaughtered ruthlessly.
I mean, I gotta just freaking command and go in there, right?
Well, I dropped her two levels for you.
Yeah, try to wipe her out. I mean, the least we can say is that the two creatures that destroyed us in this game, we at least slaughtered before the world ended, right?
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, if anything, that's a victory.
All right, ranged, it's 1v2. She gets one white, or two white, I get one white. That's a good start. Give me another one. Thank you, Daddy. All right, hey, whatever.
Yeah, but here's where the pain comes.
Yeah.
I know.
What's going on now?
Purple, two orange, and two white.
Got him. What do you got?
Black, red, orange, white.
Black, red, orange.
No, see, your power, you're more, the balance is in your favor this time.
Oh my effing Jesus.
Jesse,
every horde in play gains one threat.
Can I roll the purple die? Okay.
Every horde in play gains two threat, Jesse.
Is that immediate? Pop.
Are you effing kidding me, Jesse? Can I roll my own? Are you effing kidding me? Oh, once per round. Okay, that can't happen. It can only happen once. Drop him down a little bit. Okay, at least I read that once per round.
All right, you didn't roll any shields at least. You didn't roll any shields.
What did you roll?
Oh,
how many damage?
Oh my gosh.
Three damage, too. And a shield. Hey, one shield, so I take two damage. One, two, three, four on her, so she takes
three
damage.
Bolt.
You need to get a bolt.
So I lose two guys, right?
Yeah, but you
one of them gets to come back to a non-enemy occupied hex.
Summon one back to a non-enemy occupied hex. Okay, what'd she get this time?
Oh, Jesus. Four whites and an orange.
And what do you get?
Red, black, white.
You're still rolling.
That's not what I need.
Two shields and a hit.
Two shields?
Two shields
and a hit.
Two hits.
Okay.
You mother...
Jesse. What's the next one?
Bro, Jesse, stop!
What's the next one?
Same. I mean, she hasn't been hit. Four whites and an orange.
I got this.
And I get a red and a black.
Don't worry, buddy.
Two
shields, two hits.
They're dead. They're just gone?
The air just sucked out of the room.
These guys only have one life.
Yeah, I mean that you need other things to give them buff.
If the trolls were destroyed here, roll one black die.
Did they do a Hail Mary hit? Hey, she's down to one.
I can't separate what's happening in the game and my anger for your roles from my feelings in real life right now.
So on my turn, I'm going to command these two guys.
So this has been a really good example of how not to play Uprising.
We overreached.
But a great example of how the mechanics and structures of Uprising work that you could potentially do significantly better in. Now, just for final thoughts, just reflecting on this.
We're just going to end right here?
Oh, yeah. We're completely... I mean, I thought we might be able to win round... Like by the end of round two, be equal or greater than, and we're... I mean... This is the third time I've sat down and played through the first two chapters of this.
This was ugly.
This is the worst. I mean, I hope it was entertaining for you, the audience. I do want to say...
Your SD card's empty again, isn't it?
Probably. I will be doing a solo run of this as well. So if you want to see how my rolls work, if I'm doing all of the rolling, check that out. I mean, hopefully I'll be able... I want to sit down and play through this a few more times. Even though we got crushed in this, this leaves me wanting to get back into the game, genuinely.
100%. So here's the thing. I really want to play again, but...
Right? It's 1 a.m.
Well, not tonight. Not tonight. I don't really want to play again tonight. I have work in 6 hours.
Yeah.
With that being said... Yeah, I'm an hour away from home, too. Okay, sure. So... With that being said... I don't even know where I was going. I lost my train of thought.
You really want to play again.
I really want to play this game again. So, Jesse... What are you thinking? Can this get 2, 3, 4 videos up on this one? Because I want to play this again next week.
Man, I'm not upset about it. I really like what's going on here. And the fact that we just got crushed, like, even though from a viewing standpoint, I don't know if we showed you the best way to execute this game. I mean,
we're going to improve.
I think if it's the first time you've seen it, it may come off as a little bit of, you know, unbalanced and hard.
We just started off on the wrong... It's just like Spirit Island. If anyone's played Spirit Island
That's the comparison I like to make. Like, this to me is this chaos management cooperative. There's so much going on in your tableau. You don't really worry about other people, but you still have to talk and work together and prevent this area from being overrun. And so...
This is my favorite kind of co-op game because it's extremely difficult to make a kingmaker. Yes. Pandemic, one person can say, here's what we're going to do. We won the game.
Point A.
Spirit Island, no, there's too much going on for there to be a kingmaker.
Craps all over the board.
Right.
Look, strategically, hunting down them immediately, because we thought we could, but we forgot that I had buffed before to actually prepare.
Yeah. I mean, legitimately...
Instead of, like, gaining resources and exploring, we went straight for them. We built our havens next to them, and we know they're hunting us. Then one of them moved twice. Like,
right. It wasn't just a number of things that went, or one thing that went
and
wrong.
And it wasn't just dice rolling.
Everything.
It wasn't just dice rolling. We could have mediated for some rough dice rolling.
That does need to be discussed.
We would have killed the Lich Queen.
Yeah.
But for some.
It does need to be discussed, the dice rolling, though. I don't mind it. I think it's fine. It plays great. The dice rolling's cool. But there will be people out there that just hate it, and that's fine.
But that's going to be true when they see dice. From my experience with these dice, I've never went into a combat feeling like the dice were unbalanced for me in terms of what I thought should happen. Mm-hmm. Now, dice always give you the chance for something epic to happen right. or something tragic to happen.
I kind of expected more out of my top-notch sure. soldier.
Yeah, that was a little upset.
What I'm saying is, like, the averages, because these are custom dice, the averages and the math that I'm doing in my head, I never feel like these dice aren't performing the way I think they might.
Right. The dice did not turn me off at all, but it's just something that needs to be addressed. Yep. If someone is coming from Spirit Island and hearing us making kind of comparisons, do know that there's no dice in Spirit Island.
A little bit more Ameritrash.
Yeah, a little bit. A little bit. Well, see, but it's great.
And I passed up on this card that I probably should have just kept. Reroll dice during our archery phase.
Yep.
Up to two.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would have been...
So,
that would have changed. I mean, you would have probably killed the Lich Queen or got her down where I killed her right there. Whether we come back from that, no one knows.
The first time I played this on TTS, I was left with the same feeling that I'm left with now. I immediately walked upstairs and pulled out the prototype and set it down on the table and started looking and messing around with things because I was left with the feeling that I want to play it again. Oh, I want to try again. Yeah. And that's the same exact thing tonight. Like, I want to beat this game, and then I want to try it harder, and I want to do it again, and I want to play with different characters.
Yeah.
Tell
Cornelius, if he sends us a retail copy, he can expect 5 videos over the next month of this game.
Okay.
I mean, I don't have to edit anything. All I got to do is play. But tell Cornelius.
Yeah.
Cornelius, so, if you're watching this.
For context, my two guests here are just gamers. They're not Quackalope.
Hey, now.
Like, you don't produce the content. You don't strike. You don't talk to publishers.
Yet.
I hear what you're saying. They are going to open a game store together sooner or later.
Maybe.
But that's besides the point. So when you hear him saying, Cornelius, I'm going to try to play this solo, and it sounds like Max wants to get at the table again next week when we get together.
Yeah, so if you want to bribe us with a retail.
Stop. You're horrible. You're horrible.
I don't have to keep up like this image that you do.
I do. Well, I do like that you're excited about the game.
I really do want to play it again. Like,
I love
honest
it.
Thoughts. What are you?
Even though we got obliterated,
sure.
Like, no, hands down, I want to play it again. I think my first few plays of Spirit Island went about the same way.
Mine did too. 100%.
Took me a few to get track of how to balanced play and not overreach.
The one thing that I'm curious to see about this, and I'm not someone that's played the devil out of Spirit Island.
Sure.
And no, I mean, I love it and I've played it a lot, but I'm not someone that's played it at all scenarios, at all difficulties. Most people do have a small qualm. Most people that are addicted to Spirit Island say that you can pretty much win every time once you're super experienced with it. Like, you've got it down.
Because Spirit Island is a math problem.
Right. So I want to see how this scales.
The Ameritrash element, the luck the element to this certainly does add a different variant in there that makes it a little bit harder and more unforgiving in some ways.
And these are going
to
be different.
There's a modular nature to this that I also really like. The randomized terrain, the modularity in our story cards, and the way they come out.
And we only played 2 chapters.
Only played 2 chapters, and they could cycle out a bunch more of those. And also, I said this to the creator, and I hope down the road, I hope they get success enough to do this. I would love to see Hordes and Legions be replaced with other creatures here on this board as well. I want to experience this with other Nemesis-type things.
And that would be easy. I mean, maybe the Empire stays, because they're the ones that... But they summon from an alternate universe, an alternate dimension.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, but right now, the base game, like, we can see the Neoprene. It's set up for those two, right? It's premiered with those.
Sure.
But there's modularity here that I personally think will add to that exploration file. The same thing that they've done with Spirit Island.
Oh, yeah.
Bringing in other spirits, bringing in new classes to face, everything.
And it's
like
really exciting. How many are there? 4 of these?
Base game, there's 4.
But each...
There's going to be 8 on the Kickstarter.
Okay, 8 on the Kickstarter, assuming they are going to have 2 decks.
All of them are custom. All of them are 2-deck. Wow. There's always a male and female.
Yeah, so we played with 3 of the possible 16 decks in this game.
Yep.
And not that the decks are, like, wildly crazy different, like, game-breakingly different.
They're enough that...
But, oh, yeah.
They play different.
And this is different.
It is.
All of it's different.
Yep.
My need for food was way greater. My need for whatever this red crap is that I forgot was way less than anything needed.
I had a hard time getting
units
to the board because we had a lot of food early on, but not a lot of plunder or
whole
salt.
Whole deck of items we haven't seen, a whole bunch of quests we haven't seen, actually quite a few Nemesis hordes and legions we haven't seen.
This is a prototype copy.
Yeah, that's
like where they print like most of what's going to be in the box.
Right.
Enough to show you, right?
I'll be curious to see the quality of the components in the retail to see if it's equal, above, or lesser.
No, it'll be above.
You think so?
Yes.
Okay.
The only thing, I don't know that they'll have the neoprene mat as a core.
Maybe a Kickstarter add-on.
It may be an add-on.
I think the rulebook talks about it.
And I think the neoprene mat to me is worth it for this setup, just keeping everything stable.
Probably.
But that being said, from what I've discussed with him, custom dice, custom acrylic stands, they've actually went out of their way to make them higher quality acrylic so they feel good and so that it'll be a heat transfer art print on the front.
Not like
it. Yeah. So, I mean, this should be a beautiful game when you're getting it to the table.
And I truly love the standees.
And look at the care they've put into the artwork.
Yeah.
That alone, that's the first thing that struck me. The front cover of this game was the first thing that, to me, I was like, someone cares about this.
Yeah, they're taking it seriously.
Let's find out what they're doing, right?
I mean, this is not your average Joe prototype. This is a could-be retail right now. Prototype. I mean, they're really trying hard.
I'm excited. I like messy games, and man, this one just strikes a chord with me. And I can't wait for that lore book. I can't wait for that lore book. Whatever the case, thanks for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Like I said, stay tuned. Check out my more tight, concise preview. If you made it to this point, of course you have. Solo gameplay. I really will produce it because I feel like, or at least us two gameplay, whatever it takes.
We'll bring it back. It'll come back.
What about me?
You're welcome. I'm just saying.
It's going to happen, regardless.
Just because Max talked the whole time doesn't mean I didn't like it, too.
Damn! You're not wrong.
I ramble, man. I'm sorry.
Either next Wednesday when you guys
come
back.
I'm the one that said we should play this game.
You did. Before he ever mentioned he even had it.
So maybe what we do is the Kickstarter will be launched, but maybe next Wednesday when you guys come back, this is the thing we get to the table again.
I would not be mad.
No.
I'm really actually wanting to try it again.
Cool. Let's give it another swing. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Whatever the case, whatever you do, remember to do the important thing. Get out and play some games. We'll see you next time. Thank you. We lost so bad.
That was awful, but I loved it, dude.